Hello, kids. Welcome to day three of Concrete and Cranes with myself and Miss Christine.
Welcome. I want to start today off with a game. We're going to put on different types of hats, and then you'll tell us who wears those kinds of hats. For example, when I'm wearing this hard hat, it shows that I'm a construction worker. Okay, let's play. Pastor Howard, you can start.
All right. Boys and girls, who wears a hat just like this?
Ooh.
Right. A baseball player wears a baseball cap.
Exactly. And who wears a hat like this? It's an astronaut.
Here we go. How about this one? Who wears a hat just like this? That's right. Someone who's going to a party. That's great. Great job, boys and girls. You really know how to guess who wears what kind of hat.
And you kids also know what it's like to be building on the love of Jesus together.
And sometimes, well, life can be like a hard hat zone. But even in the toughest times, Jesus is always loving us, no matter what.
That's right. Jesus loves us with a great love. And that reminds me of John 15:13. What it says is, no one has greater love than this, to lay down his life for his friends.
That's a great love.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to learning more about that great love. So I guess we better put on our hard hats.
Well, let's put on our thinking caps too, because we will have a lot of good things to think about today.
Well, but I can't find my thinking cap. I don't know where it is. What does it look like?
A thinking cap isn't real. It's just something that people say. It means to get ready, to think. Are you ready, friends? To think, learn, play, sing, and laugh together.
I am.
That's awesome. So stand up. We're going to start with our theme song for today.
We're so happy you've joined us today. Let's sing together.
Construction has begun. Rhythms and Mayette again. I love hanging out with you at Virtual VBS, Concrete and Cranes. And for those who are taking part in our family VBS option, I love seeing you in person too. Keep taking those pictures and sharing those videos. We love to see what God is doing through this year's Vacation Bible School. Now, I want to see if you've been practicing our motto and scripture for this week. Do you remember them? Let's start with our motto. Our motto is, Jesus is our strong foundation. Let's do that again. Make sure you do the motions too. Ready? Jesus is our strong foundation. That is so important to remember, boys and girls. Also, don't forget our memory verse from Philippians chapter 1, verse 6. I am sure of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on until completion, until the day of Jesus Christ. I love that verse. It reminds me that Jesus is my strong foundation and he will never give up on me or you. All right, it's game time.
Hey kids, welcome back to day 3. It is game time with Miss Christine and Pastor Joel. Today's game is called Head, Shoulders, Knees, and Cone. So how this game is going to be played, I'm going to yell out random things for them to do. Either touch their head, their knees, their shoulders, or the cone. Once I yell cone, they have to see who can grab the cone the fastest. We're going to do one trial run so you can kind of get an idea, and then we'll play best out of 5. You two ready?
Oh, we're ready.
Yeah.
All right. So, here we go. Head, knees, shoulder, head, cone.
No. Woo!
Wowzers. All right. I don't think you need to see that again. So, we'll do best out of 3 at your house. Why don't you guys do best out of 5? All right. This time it's for real. Head, shoulder, knees, head, shoulder, knees, head, knees, shoulder, knees, cone. Pastor Joel's got 1. Knees, head, shoulder, knees, knees, shoulder, cone.
Oh! He's so fast.
He's got 2. Last one right here.
All right, I got this. He's got to stay really focused.
Head, shoulder, knees, head, shoulder, knees, shoulder, head, shoulder. Head, cone. Ah! Oh. And we have our winner. Have fun playing at home.
It was not such a good start for the young builder. Renzo had smarts, but that's not the same as having wisdom. He had a lot to discover about building things.
Renzo, a competition is doing it faster. Cobra Comb Construction has finished the foundation.
What? How is that possible? We started at the same time.
I didn't know cobras use combs.
I think it's metaphoric.
He's how they're beating us.
Yeehaw! In the dust, Renzo, right?
That's Foreman Niemeyer, the most ruthless and underhanded contractor in the business. If he's involved, we better watch our back.
Hey, Renzo, see this load of girders? That means tomorrow we start building up to the sky. What do you have? Oh, you got a hole in the ground. Tough luck, Renzo. A hole in the ground.
Holes are just upside down mountains.
Hey, guess what? It's quitting time, boys.
Come on, Lloyd.
Ooh, what are we doing?
Getting to the truth. Lloyd, don't make a sound. Starting now.
I shall call him Growly.
Lloyd!
Run! that? Oh, should I give him a turnip bone?
Floyd, what are you doing?
Oh, I think I'm moving it with my mind.
Floyd, it's Norman Niemeyer!
I hope you're not afraid of heights, Renzo. Renzo's got a hole in the ground. Renzo's got a hole in the ground. Renzo's got a hole in the ground. And now he's up a tree.
Wee!
Floyd, I've never been this high up. I'm scared.
Don't worry, Renzo. I'll save us.
Hi, Renzo.
I'm not feeling safe, Floyd.
She'll call you Growly Junior.
That's the last straw, kid.
Before you yell, more, let me just say I know how Foreman Niemeyer is beating us.
Go on.
It's easy to build fast when you skip the most important part. Most houses we live in are built on the ground. Pour a little concrete, let it settle a while, and that's okay for a house. But this is a skyscraper. They skipped building a strong foundation.
The higher you build a skyscraper, the stronger the foundation must be. Workers must blast into the solid rock found deep beneath the soil. This supports the entire building and keeps it standing, whatever storm may come.
Mr. Santiago, I'm sorry for being such a goofus.
You're forgiven, kid. So, we gonna build a strong foundation, or what?
You bet!
Just like a skyscraper's foundation is essential, so are the foundations you are building in your life. Foundations of love and family, and the most important, the foundation in our Heavenly Father. When we follow Jesus, we are digging a deep foundation to prepare us for the good days and the hard ones.
Okay, we have a solid foundation. Now, we head for the clouds.
Hi, boys and girls. I am excited for our Bible story today. It is all about what Jesus did the night right before he died on the cross for you and for me. Let me ask you a question before we get started. What do you care about? Seriously, share with someone next to you. What is your most prized possession? Well, I brought something that I care about a lot with me today. This is my cell phone, and stored inside are precious pictures of my family and my friends. Also, I use it to pay bills and play games, check my email. This is very important to me. But the good news is that Jesus loves us, and he chose to die for us because we matter to him. Jesus thinks that you are way more valuable than my phone or any other treasure that you can think of. He loves you, and you matter to him, and that is why he was willing to die for you. So I want you to shout out these truths with me. The first one is, Jesus died for me. Go ahead, try it. 3, 2, 1. Jesus died for me. Now let's do the second. It is, I matter to him. Go ahead. 3, 2, 1. I matter to him. That is what we see in our Bible story today. It is in Matthew 26:39. Remember, this is Jesus the night before he's crucified. He was praying, knowing he's about to die. Jesus prayed in the garden. Jesus and his disciples walked to a place called Gethsemane. It was a garden near the bottom of a mountain. Jesus said to the men, "Sit here while I go pray." Then Jesus told Peter and two other disciples, James and John, to go with him. Jesus became quiet. He began to think about the plan God had for him and the things that would happen soon. Jesus told his disciples he was sad and wanted them to stay near him. While Peter, James, and John waited, Jesus walked a little farther away. He fell down on the ground and prayed. Jesus asked God to help him. "Whatever you want, God, I will do," Jesus said.
Jesus walked back to the disciples. He found them sleeping. "Stay awake and pray," Jesus said to the men. Jesus walked away again to pray some more. When he finished, he went back to the disciples, and they were still sleeping. So Jesus went to pray again. He asked God to help him be ready to do God's plan. When Jesus finished praying, he returned to his disciples. He told them to get up and leave the garden with him. Jesus is totally surrendered to God's will. He knew that in order for us to have a personal relationship with God, to have eternal life, he had to go to the cross. Because of our sin, we deserve to die. But he took our place. He chose to go to the cross because you mattered that much to him. He chooses to die for you. You are loved so by Jesus that he chooses to die for you. And that is the great news that we get to celebrate today.
Christine?
And you're wearing yours.
Well, you know those other hats, the astronaut helmet and the baseball cap and the party hat? Well, they didn't fit quite right. So I think I'm sticking with my hard hat.
I am too. And my thinking cap.
Now I'm going to have to think about that one.
Well, what did you think about what we learned today? That Jesus chose to die for you and for me, and for all those kids out there.
Jesus chose to die for me. You know what? That reminds me of the foundation of worth that we built on today. Jesus says we are worthy of God's love.
And we should see others the same way too. Not just our friends, but everyone we meet. So, do you still have your thinking cap on?
I think so. I keep it right under my hard hat. Well, kids, it has been such a fun day at Virtual VBS. We can't wait to see you tomorrow.
See you then.